2011, we published with Villegas Editores Birds of Colombia. And it was just such a pleasant experience working with them. They were so professional. The country's huge. There's a lot of, you know, marketplace and a lot of opportunity. And they didn't have any books on their birds, so they really needed this material for conservation purposes. And Colombians are very, there's a lot of national pride in Colombia. So, you know, they deserve this book, being the, you know, the best in the world. And so once we brought out Birds of Colombia and we saw, you know, the easy logistics, and I knew the country so well, I wanted to see what else we could do. And the obvious choice would be Hummingbirds of Colombia. So in 2012, I started work on Hummingbirds of Colombia, because when I did the bird book, it was a mix of birds and hummingbirds, but generally more birds than hummingbirds, I'd say. And so I started there. It was maybe 3 months of field work, a little bit less, because, you know, hummingbirds are a little bit easier. There's a lot of feeders around the country. It's something kind of recent still in Colombia, but there's now some good areas where you get a bunch of species. But then I would still say 50% of the species are not coming into feeders, so you have to go and find them, you know, traditional in the forest hunting. And it was phenomenal. I mean, Colombia has some of the most incredible hummingbirds, like a bearded helmet crest, stuff that we don't have in Ecuador. Well, I live in neighboring Ecuador, and got a golden-bellied star frontlet. The list goes on, but they've got some incredible hummingbirds. And then up in Santa Marta in the north, they've got some really good species and some endemic stuff. And I was pretty lucky with a couple of really good species, which, you know, because hummingbirds generally aren't, you know, that endangered, but Colombia has some, like, seriously endangered ones. And there's actually some, like, mythical ones like that. Well, I know the Spanish name for it, but it's the Frontino, in the Paramos of Frontino, in Antioquia, in the department of Antioquia. There's a hummingbird that had disappeared for, like, 60 years. There were some records really way back, but nobody had seen it again. So this recently it was kind of rediscovered, and we went back in there, and it was a hell of a mission to find it, and way up in the Andes, but we did find it. So we looked hard always at finding the rare ones first, because that's the stuff that tells a more important conservation story, I'd say. But yeah, 3 months of work, we've got maybe 100 species in the book of the 336 that there are in Colombia. I mean, I did take more species, but the book ended up being just more concise than like, well, Birds of Colombia was a big book, you know, it's 400-500 pages almost. So Hummingbirds of Colombia is 160 pages or something, but it's 100 species of the 330, but definitely I think a representation of some of the rarer ones and some of the more sexy ones.